In this video, we will go for types of ICR and we will also locate all ICRs for shown configuration of 4-bar mechanism. There are three types of ICR: fixed ICR, permanent ICR, neither fixed nor permanent ICR. We will discuss these ICRs. On screen, 4-bar mechanism is shown. There are 4 links in it: AB, BC, CD and AD. Link AD is fixed link. Now let us give number to links. Let us say fixed link AD is link number 1. Input link AB is marked as link number 2. Coupler link BC is marked as link number 3. And output link CD is marked as link number 4. Number of ICRs will be given by relation n is equal to n into n minus 1 divided by 2. As there are 4 links, therefore number of ICRs n will be equal to 4 into 4 minus 1 divided by 2, which will be equal to 6. Therefore n will be equal to 6, hence number of ICRs will be 6. Now we will write the 6 ICRs. As there are 4 links, in first row we will write link 1, 2, 3 and 4. In next row we will write ICR I12. Next ICR will be I23 and next ICR will be I34. In next row we will write ICR I13 and next ICR will be I24. In last row we will have ICR I14. Now we will locate these 6 ICRs. Between link number 1 and link number 2, there is a turning pair at point A. Hence, ICR I12 for relative motion between link number 1 and link number 2 will be at point A. That is, I12 will be at turning pair between link number 1 and 2. Between link number 1 and link number 4, there is a turning pair at point D. Hence, ICR I14 for relative motion between link number 1 and link number 4 will be at point D. That is, I14 will be at turning pair between link number 1 and 4. Whenever this mechanism will operate, links will change their position, but fixed link will not move as it is fixed. Means position of point B and C will change, but position of point A and D will not change. Hence, ICR I12 and ICR I14 will never change their position when mechanism will operate. Hence, these ICRs are known as fixed ICRs, as position of these ICRs will never change. Between link number 2 and link number 3, there is a turning pair at point B. Hence, ICR I23 for relative motion between link number 2 and link number 3 will be at point B. That is, I23 will be at turning pair between link number 2 and 3. Similarly, between link number 3 and link number 4, there is a turning pair at point C. Hence, ICR I34 for relative motion between link number 3 and link number 4 will be at point C. That is, I34 will be at turning pair between link number 3 and 4. Whenever this mechanism will operate, links will change their positions. Means position of point B and C will change. Hence, ICR I23 and ICR I34 will change their position, but I23 will be always at turning pair between link number 2 and 3. Hence, it is known as permanent ICR. Similarly, I34 will be always at turning pair between link number 3 and 4. Hence, it is known as permanent ICR. Fixed ICRs will never change their position. Permanent ICRs will change their position but permanent ICRs will be always at joint of respective links. ICRs which are not fixed and permanent are known as neither fixed nor permanent ICRs. ICR I12 and I14 are fixed ICR, while ICR I23 and I34 are permanent ICR. We have marked or located 4 ICRs, I12, I23, I34 and I14, but there are total 6 ICRs. 2 ICRs are not marked or located yet. This remaining 2 ICRs, that is I13 and I24, are neither fixed nor permanent ICR in this case. To locate neither fixed nor permanent ICRs, we will need Kennedy's theorem. Draw a circle with any radius. On the circumference of that circle, mark 4 points, 1, 2, 3 and 4. These 4 points are representing 4 links of mechanism. We have located ICR I12. Hence, in circle diagram, draw a line joining 1 and 2. This line is representing ICR I12. We have located ICR I23. Hence, in circle diagram, draw a line joining 2 and 3. This line in circle diagram is representing ICR I23. Similarly, we have located ICR I34. Hence, in circle diagram, draw a line joining 3 and 4. We have also located ICR I14. Hence, in circle diagram, draw a line joining 1 and 4. In circle diagram, lines are representing ICRs. Here, you can notice line is not drawn between point 1 and 3 because I13 is not located yet. Similarly, line is not drawn between point 2 and 4 because ICR I24 is not located yet. Now we will locate ICR I13. To locate I13, in circle diagram, find two triangles with 1-3 as a common side. In circle diagram, two triangles with 1-3 as a common side are triangle 1-2-3 and triangle 1-3-4. In triangle 1-2-3, numbers are taken in ascending order. Similarly, in triangle 1-3-4, numbers are taken in ascending order. As we have to locate ICR I13, hence, from circle diagram, we have taken two triangles with 1-3 as a common side, that is triangle 1-2-3 and triangle 1-3-4. Now we will focus on triangle 1-2-3. In triangle 1-2-3, link 1, link 2 and link 3 is involved. For these three links, possible ICRs or possible combination of two bodies will be 3. That is I12, I23 and I13. Each ICR will represent side of triangle 1-2-3. Out of these three ICRs, I12, I23 and I13, I13 is already written. Hence, we will write remaining two ICRs, that is I12 and I23. Draw line passing through I12 and I23. Now, we will focus on other triangle 1-3-4. In triangle 1-3-4, link 1, link 3 and link 4 is involved. For these three links, possible ICRs or possible combination of two bodies will be 3. That is I13, I34 and I14. Each ICR will represent side of triangle 1-3-4. Out of these three ICRs, I13, I34 and I14, I13 is already written. Hence, we will write remaining two ICRs, I14 and I34. Draw a line passing through I14 and I34. Line passing through I14 and I34 will intersect line passing through I12 and I23. At the intersection of these two lines, we will have ICR I-13. How I-13 is located at the intersection of lines? In circle diagram, points on the circumference of circle are representing links, and lines in circle diagram are representing ICRs. To locate I-13 from circle diagram, we have taken two triangles with 1-3 as a common side. These two triangles are triangle 1-2-3 and triangle 1-3-4. In triangle 1-2-3, three links are involved, that is 1, 2, and 3, and there is relative motion between link 1, 2, and 3. According to Kennedy's theorem, if there are three links having motion relative to each other, then for those three links we will have three ICRs, and those three ICRs will lie on same line, or those three ICRs will be collinear. In triangle 1, 2, 3, three links involved are 1, 2 and 3. For these three links, possible three ICRs or possible combination of two bodies will be three, that is I-12, I-23 and I-13. Out of these three ICRs, I-12, I-23 and I-13, I-13 is already written. Hence, we will write remaining two ICRs, that is I-12 and I-23. According to Kennedy's theorem, I-12, I-23 and I-13 will lie on same line, as there is a relative motion between link 1, 2 and 3. We are knowing I-12 and I-23. So we will draw line passing through I-12 and I-23, and according to Kennedy's theorem, on the same line we will have ICR I-13. But where it is, that we don't know. To locate I-13 from circle diagram, we have taken two triangles with 1-3 as a common side. These two triangles are triangle 1-2-3 and triangle 1-3-4. Now, in triangle 1-3-4, three links are involved, that is 1-3 and 4, and there is relative motion between link 1-3 and 4. According to Kennedy's theorem, if there are three links having motion relative to each other, then for those three links we will have three ICRs, and those three ICRs will lie on same line, or those three ICRs will be collinear. In triangle 1-3-4, three links involved are 1-3 and 4. For these three links, possible three ICRs or possible combination of two bodies will be three, that is I-13, I-34 and I-14. Out of these three ICRs, I-13, I-34 and I-14, I-13 is already written. Hence, we will write remaining two ICRs, that is I-14 and I-34. According to Kennedy's theorem, I-13, I-34 and I-14 will lie on same line, as there is relative motion between link 1-3 and 4. We are knowing I-14 and I-34, so we will draw line passing through I-14 and I-34, and according to Kennedy's theorem, on the same line we will have ICR I-13. But where it is, that we don't know. I-13 is also going to lie on line passing through I-12 and I-23. Same point can lie on two different lines only at the point of intersection. Hence, at the intersection, we will have ICR I-13. As I-13 is located, hence in circle diagram, draw a line joining 1 and 3, and as I-13 is located first, on it we will write Roman digit 1. Every time, there is no need to think about Kennedy's theorem. We can go for this process mechanically. Now, to locate I-24, in circle diagram, find two triangles with 2-4 as a common side. In circle diagram, two triangles with 2-4 as a common side are triangle 2-3-4 and triangle 1-2-4. Now, we will focus on triangle 2-3-4. in triangle 2-3-4, link 2, link 3 and link 4 is involved. For these three links, possible ICRs or possible combination of two bodies or links will be 3. That is I23, I34 and I24. Out of these three ICRs, that is I23, I34 and I24, I24 is already written. Hence, we will write remaining two ICRs, that is I23 and I34. Now we will focus on other triangle 1-2-4. Link 1, link 2 and link 4 is involved. For these three links, possible ICRs or possible combination of two bodies or links will be 3. That is I12, I24 and I14. Out of these three ICRs, that is I12, I24 and I14, I24 is already written. Hence, we will write remaining two ICRs, that is I12 and I14. Draw line passing through I23 and I34. Draw line passing through I12 and I14. At the intersection of these two lines, we will have ICR I24. As I24 is located, hence in circle diagram, draw line joining 2 and 4, and as it is located after I13, on it we will write Roman digit 2. After observing those Roman digits, we will come to know that first we have located I13 and then I24 is located. Now we have located all 6 ICRs.